Today I am going to show you my 3 axis gimbal which is chest mounted, which I can stabilize my MTB videos. So this is the box that arrived from Aliexpress delivery, and on the packet it's written as camera bracket, which clearly it is not. However, those are the tricks of the trade that those guys use. On opening the box, I can see that there's a good amount of air bubble wrapping on it. I was able to open it quickly, a few staples that I had to quickly open, and this is the box. It's written 3 axis pan tilt. They forgot the rolling motion, but anyways, here is the box. I have ordered the white color gimbal, which is a kind of an aluminium color that we'll be seeing in a couple of minutes. Here on the box, it's tightly packed. Again, there's another bubble wrapping. Now there are a few connectors. Something that we should know is that this gimbal is meant for the RC drones. However, I'm going to chest mount and I won't need these connectors which are going to be used by the RC. There's a one page document which explains what the gimbal is about, and some things like the software version, the hardware version of the controller is explained on that pamphlet. So here is the gimbal, which has a couple of plates which are aluminium, and then again there are a set of 3 motors which are connected on a 90 degree angle to control each axis, the X, Y and Z axis, that's the pitch, roll and yaw axis. I have one connector and something which is coming out loose, and then the other 3 motors, and there's a kind of a strap for my GoPro. So the gimbal looks brand new and shiny, and let me try to check out the other parts. Something which has come out loose, this is the connection from the IMU. There should not be any static, so it's rolled against a magnet, I guess. The IMU is the inertial measurement unit which goes on the base plate. So here I have connected my GoPro on that camera, and this is the final look of the gimbal. Next, I will be trying out to connect the gimbal to my battery. So this is the battery, which is a 2200 mAh 3-cell 11 volts 40C battery. This is a 3S battery, which is a 3-cell battery, and here the gimbal is powered on. What I will need to do is I will need to hold it in a very stationary and horizontal position, as though it's hanging from a RC drone. Now there's the flickering, that means it's calibrated, and it will give me a few beeps before I will be able to use the gimbal. Yep, that was the signal, and I'm off. I'll just check all the kind of axis, and it's remaining pretty stable all around. There is a subtle movement, but I believe I need to enable the second IMU of this gimbal, as it's not already enabled. The Storm 32 base gimbal controller tool is what will help me in doing that. I'll be doing that later before shooting the videos. And here I'm trying out the roll, the pitch and the yaw. So if I can quickly take you through the description, the driver board is Storm 32 BGC and the firmware is at a level, the hardware is V130. The working voltage is 3 to 4 cell batteries and 350 mAh, and the other instructions. A few instructions to mount the gimbal on the RC drone, which we won't need, but this is the wiring diagram that we will need to see. There are a few connectors on that as well. Before getting this gimbal, I had brought a 2-axis gimbal which I had fried the board off while soldering the wire, so those diagrams are pretty essential. This is the gimbal, and on the top plate I will be mounting my GoPro brackets. That's the contraption that I will be using, that is the angle that I will be creating. So let's see how I am able to mount that on my chest and how it works. This is the contraption. I am able to pitch myself front and back, but still the GoPro remains stable. This is the pan mode which follows me on the pan. I can change that mode as well. And this is the roll that I am trying to do. I am going from one side to the other side and it's pretty stable.
Let's see how this thing performs.
Here I am on the road trying to forge through the Mumbai traffic, as there's a bit of noise coming out of the vibration, but trust me, I could not hear that motor sound. I believe because of contact that sound is coming. Oops, there's a rickshaw. I need to be very careful here. Few puddles because of the Mumbai monsoon that just come out. And here, if you can see, I am going through some speed bumps, the speed breakers, without any vibration of the video. I am able to pan without any glitches. There is no vibration whatsoever in the video. I am so in love with this video. And now Piyush is unable, is not giving me any side. There's the bus. This is the double speed that I am doing on that video on the lanes on the road. And if you can see, I'm moving from left to right and there's no movement. Here comes another speed breaker, and without losing any speed I'm going through it, and the camera did not shake at all. Here's the nasty traffic that I'm going to tell you, and oops, I just missed the scooter. And here comes the 4x4. Oops. And now the finale, the off-road sections. I did not see that pedal. Ah, my handlebar is going from 90 degrees to 90 degrees, and still the GoPro is panning it out fine. Here are a few puddles that I'm gonna miss, and here is a good section that I am doing. For a comparison, I will do a comparison of my last week's video which I did not have a mount, a 3-axis gimbal, and it shaked as hell. Here is a comparison. Beautiful, beautiful stability from the gimbal. I can see the trees clearly. I can even count the branches, but on the left, it's a mess.
So guys, I just had a test of my chest mounted gimbal. So I've just had a run from this path all the way over there. There's another second route of Tarzan Point which I was unable to make because of waterlogging. The lake is filled to the brim and it has stopped the cross path, and it's raining. I need to get indoors. See ya, bye. For more amazing videos and exciting and thrilling routes, subscribe to my channel, Beautygraphy.